this match scheduled.
Well, hello there! As Ivan Reaver is making his entrance! We've got a bigger budget now! This is IWD's 25th show, our 5th pay-per-view, the Kingdom of
Punishment. This is an exciting pay-per-view with exciting matchups tonight.
Yeah, this opening match is the final in the tournament. The winner will advance to take on TJ Eclipse, as far as we know in that. And then, obviously, the winner of Striker vs. Pitbull will advance after that. For the final for the world title, the IWD world title is online. Look at the crowd! We haven't got like 10 people now! Look at them people! We're popular!
This is amazing!
Yeah, feel the atmosphere! Yeah! And the first ever official entrance is Ivan Reaver. What do you think his chances are on this? This is an elimination match as well, by the way.
It's a very big match in his career, but I think he has it in the bag here. He's got talent.
Definitely. Like, who's coming out next out of the next three?
Crusher!
And of course, if Crusher loses, he's still fired. He has to win the tournament to keep his job. I think the favourites have to be Crusher or Ivan for this match. What do you think?
I don't know. There's going to be a lot of great wrestlers competing in this match. I can't really give it to anyone early right now.
Yeah, I can't wait. This match is going to be awesome. Look at the fireworks. Feel the power of the heat. Oh, it's making me sweat. As Crusher slowly makes his way to the ring. Look at Ivan staring him down. Look at the spotlights. We can flood lights now on top of him. They're looking at it like, whoa, crushed it then. Get a bit of their own personality out now. And the next person in this little four-way elimination match. This is the final of the tournament, remember. The final of the tournament. This guy is Theodore, the current commissioner, who will wrestle later tonight against Sir David's commissionership on the line. So he's minimum got 2 matches tonight. But if he wins this, he would advance to face TJ Eclipse, his own leader. If he, some miracle, wins that, he would advance to the main event. He will have 4 matches tonight if he can win all these. And at the end of the night, he could be the commissioner and the world champion. And if he loses, he would have nothing. What's your thoughts on it, Tyler?
Well, like you said, it's all or nothing. He's got to go in 100% and give it his all. And hopefully he comes out on top, because if he doesn't, he's walking away out of this arena with nothing.
Yep, definitely. And the next person who's coming out next will also be competing twice tonight. He's competing in this world tournament. So again, he could advance for the world title. And he's also already got an extreme title match opportunity against Happy Man in their 4-way match they're having. Was it 4 or 3-way? I can't remember. There's so many matches going on. It's incredible.
Bryce is making his entrance into this 4-man elimination match. This is exciting.
This is awesome. Look at the fire. You know what it is? He's got a similar entrance to Crusher. Must be because it's his pro shape. That's the thing. Crusher's in there with Bryce. Basically, his little mentor could get him fired. Or Crusher could stop Bryce's world title dreams. So much at stake here. So much at stake. It's incredible. Once he gets in the ring, we will cut to the opening credits, and then this match will begin. This wild main, well, it's not a main event, but this opening match will begin.
It's got potential to be a main event.
Yeah, it feels like it already. Wow. We're going to fight. Oh, isn't that cool? That cost us a lot of money, that did. Wow, as we go to the start. Well, hello there, and welcome to IVATOPIA'S Wrestling Domination. This is Chronic Pain, Show Kingdom of Punishment. Name is Pro Wrestling X, currently in early access on Steam, where you can buy it, as you can see from the link on the screen. Me, IVATOPIA, and my cousin, who's going to be helping out with this, have nothing to do with the game other than buying it and playing it and enjoying it. And I'd also like to add, the opening music you can hear right now is from the title screen of the Pro Wrestling X game itself. Hope you enjoy. Okay, we're back. The final of the World Tournament Elimination match is next. Like we said, Ivan Reaver vs. Crusher vs. Theodore vs. Bryce. The best. Then after that, the winner moves on to the main event for the IWD World title. A Striker and Pitbull. Following that match, the winner moves on to the main event for the IWD title again. The World title's online. TJ Eclipse. We don't know his opponent yet. And following that, he's going to be Happy Man over the Tiger Bryce for the Extreme Championship. And following that, the winner is the commissioner, either Theodore or Sir Dave. And then finally, we don't know the main event, because it's the people who advance will be in the main event for the world title. That's right, the world title will be on the line twice tonight, twice, as we begin this match officially. What's your thoughts, Tyler Steele?
This is very exciting going into this match, knowing how many other matches
there
are.
He caught me then, slammed him down.
It's a very great maneuver.
I'm
really excited. I want to see who comes out on top. I guess we're going to see who's the best.
Yeah, definitely. And whoever wins this, it's got another 2 matches to go. One more and it could become world champ, but then they'll have to defend it tonight if they do. So they'll have 3 matches which they want to work out as the world champion. leave tonight as a world champ, because they could tell he'd win it next match and then lose the main event.
Low blow to Theodore.
Oh, I haven't got walloped then. This is back and forth already.
Oh, what a nice jawbreaker.
I'm getting a... In the back, apparently we got a pre-recorded of Theodore had something to say before this match started, as Ivan goes high. Before I go out there tonight, I just want to announce to everybody about the World Tournament. Grimhold, who currently isn't in it, who's the World Champ, has to be. I flipped the coin earlier tonight, and it turns out, basically we'll find out what match he's going to be in, and he's going to be in TJ's match, and also the winner of the tournament. What, by the way, I will win after I defeat Ivan Reaver, and defeat Bryce, the not-so-best, and of course, end Crusher's career, because if he doesn't win, he's fired. Still.
So do you think he'll win the match?
Grimhold?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know, because he's going to be with TJ and one of these four men. So, it depends on it. Imagine if it's Crusher. They're really good friends. Imagine if it's Bryce. Bryce has got a bone to pick with him, because actually Crusher got Grimhold to test him the other week. That was literally last week, wasn't it? Or yesterday. And obviously Ivan, you know him and Grimhold have had stuff in the past. Wasn't Ivan's first ever win and Grimhold's first ever loss to Ivan? And actually, Ivan was first ever pinned by Grimhold as well for later on. And of course, Theodore. Well, I don't know. I don't know, because his head could be focused on the commissionership. To me, he's the most disadvantage in this. And also, if he's in there with his leader, TJ, surely he's going to help TJ win. What's your thoughts on it?
Yeah, I guess it all depends on who's all in the match. What the history status is, you know, what the friendship status is, will determine the outcome of the match. Ivan has a pre-recorded message. Let's look at it now.
I'm here tonight to do as I said. I am going to become the world champion for IWD. My first match is to win the tournament. My second match, I will win the title. And my final match, the main event, I will defend my title, walk away as the IWD world champion. Because it's Reaver time, and Happy Man, he will go on and he will defend his Extreme title too. It's going to be coming up, Happy Man and Ivan Reaver time. We're back. While Ivan was talking, we saw an amazing move by Ivan, actually. That moonsault from top rope broke up Crusher while he was in a dragon sleeper with Bryce. Or was it the way around between them two? Either way, that was an amazing move. He just flattened them. What's your thoughts? What Ivan just had to say as his match continues?
Well, he could be the...
Oh, again, amazing line salt.
He could be the new world champ. I mean, he could be it. He could be the next guy that, you know.
Definitely, finally. He's gone for that belt, and he's been focused since day one. We're like 5 months since the company's been going, and he's yet to get that belt around his waist.
But he has to remember he's not the only one that will do anything to get there.
Yep. I like the way when you said that, he low-blowed some people. Not the only one. Well, I will. This is an awesome match so far. Look at him. Beautiful speed by Theodore. As Ivan's bouncing off the ropes again. Oh, he caught by Bryce out of nowhere. Bryce has been very impressive in this match. And obviously the favourites, I have to say, would be Ivan and Crusher. The underdogs, he is definitely Theodore!
Wow!
He's straight on his feet, see that? He caught him, he got straight back to his feet. And Bryce. Oh,
oh
Ivan's bleeding.
Oh my gosh, Ivan's bleeding.
He's the first one. That's not going
to
help him.
Got back to his feet here. A nice moonsault just crushing Crusher.
Yeah, that was basically, you see his arm corner, he was like an upside down clothesline. Whoa, look at the speed of Bryce! Back and forth, he's ducking Crusher! Whoa, he's over Crusher's legs! Ivan's going top rope! Look at this, that back and forth! Ivan! Oh, Ivan put a stop to it!
I mean, like, that was unhumanly fast.
Yeah, he was like under Crusher, he was throwing at me, then leaping over his head. Oh, that was incredible! Then Ivan just splatting them. Double drop kick, theoretically.
Wow, nice teamwork.
Well, different opponents.
Yeah, it wasn't intended, but it was.
If it was a tag team, that would have been a great syndication. Oh,
wow,
I'm going to take him
nice
down.
Nice slam.
Oh, in the back, in a minute, we got another pre-recorded message for Crusher. Crusher has something to say, as Crusher is bleeding in front of her eyes. The two hot favourites of this match are bleeding. Wow. I guess we go to the back now and see what Crusher had to say early. He's in the night.
Bryce, the best, is in the same ring as me. I don't know what to say, really. It's time to shine, kid. End my career. Keep me on the bench. And I'm still your manager. But guess what? It's not going to happen, because you know why? Because I'm going to destroy you if you get in my way. If you're not limited by someone else, I will crush you and advance, get my career back and become the new IWD World Champion.
And we're back as Ivan goes flying. Fighting words by Crusher then, I felt, even though he's basically telling Bryce to end his career and he was to be his manager. That was awesome to say that, but he said it's not going to happen because, you know, he's Crusher and Bryce has kind of been failing of late. What's your thoughts on what was just said?
Well, what I got from that is he's willing to do anything, and he will literally crush his protege to become the new world champ.
And to get his career back. So remember, if he wins the tournament, walks out with the belt tonight, he's rehired. He's only here temporarily, technically. He loses this match, he's gone. If he advances to the next match and loses that, he's gone. He advances the next match, wins it, and then goes in the final and loses, he's gone. But if he loses at that point, he's already the world champ. But he lost the belt at that point. So at least he would retire as a world champion. Well, a former world champ. Oh, back and forth, this match is going back and forth. It's like crazy trying to keep up with it. Look at that side. No, Gary, we riot. We want Gary, we want Gary, we want Gary, we want Gary. Remember, Gary's not assigned to the pay-per-view tonight. Because he lost in the tournament.
But that does not mean he will not make a surprise appearance.
You never know with that guy. Also, who else is not signed? I think Von Kell's not signed to be here tonight. Oh, beautiful dropkick. Obviously, Tiger wasn't, but then he got announced by Theodore that he's... Because Ivan's interference, he's going to be put into the match. So he's getting an extreme title match now. You know, when he went loopy. Oh, what a match. Oh, what a kendo that was. What do you mean? I didn't even see a kendo. I'm getting that confused. I'm thinking kendo, but there's no kendos.
Wow. What a nice little drag there.
And what a nice drop kick,
putting
too.
Putting Theodore right in his back.
Definitely. Oh, look at them fists. Oh,
what a nice strike. Got a new grapple here.
Is it a power driver? Power, yep, it is. Oh, we got in the back. Grimhold's got something to say. The world champ's got something to say. Let go in here. What the world champ's got to say. The current world champion, Grimhold. Oh, wait. There's a pin. We're going to put Grimhold in sack. Crush it, been pinned by Theodore. Crush it out. He's fired again. We have to go to Grimhold quickly.
As the world champion, I'm watching this match very closely. It's a shame I won't go against my friend Crusher, because that would have been an epic battle. But of course, it don't matter who it is, because it's going to be very grim for any of them. If it ends up being Ivan Reaver, so what? I'll destroy him if it ends up being Bryce the Best. I destroyed him the other night. If it ends to be Theodore, I will destroy him, because I'm the world champion and it's staying around my waist.
Back as Crusher is leaving the arena. Look at him go. Wait, what's this? No, he's not leaving. He's turned around just to watch the match. Oh, he must be watching his protege. Oh, she's having almost whip his neck off.
See, I mean, he's not letting his emotions take over. It's a very respectful thing to do, to watch, you know, his protege, you know, someone he taught all of his talent to, all his moves.
Definitely. What's your thoughts on what Grimhold just had to say? Basically, he doesn't care who out of these it is, he's going to beat him, basically.
I mean, having a belt around your waist and looking at it and, you know, raising your eyebrows, wow, I'm the world champ, and I'll do absolutely anything to keep it.
Double low blow.
It's a big burden to carry, but I mean...
I like the way you're saying to do anything to keep it, and Ivan would low blow someone when you say it. It's like he hears you. Low blow, yeah, I'm doing anything. As you say it.
But I mean, as a world champ, you have to be willing to do anything.
Definitely.
To keep it.
Definitely. And the thing what makes Grimhold special, he's the only person in IWD's history who is a former extreme champion and he's current world champ. He's had both of our titles. The top belts in our industry, he's had both. Separate times, but he's had both. No one's done that yet. Ivan is one of the favourites to win this match. He's yet to have a belt around his waist. Crusher was a favourite. He's fighting and hasn't had a belt. I don't think Theodore's even had a belt. Oh, Bryce, none of these four have had a belt before. So we could be crowned a brand new world champion. And not just, you know, like a second world champ or a third.
Ooh, what a nice moonsault.
Oh, he slid out the ring. Oh, he's back in. The speed of Ivan pulled himself back in the ring. He slid under the ropes and died back in quick. Then got caught by Bryce.
What a drop kick.
Yeah, that was beautiful by Bryce. Who we give this match to now that Crusher's not in it?
I would say that Ivan has the advantage going in here. I mean, yeah, his face is cut open, but it seems like that's not slowing him down too much.
Definitely not. And to me, he's just as fast as Bryce, and he's technically... I would say Crusher was the strongest guy in the match now, but with him gone, Ivan's probably... Wow. Him and Theodore's between them two is the strongest now. Oh!
Going for a pin here.
He brainbusted him, and Bryce out of nowhere!
One, two!
The opportunity
three.
Is pinned Ivan!
Wow!
The opportunity is pinned Ivan! Ivan Reaver is out!
Bryce, the best Schaefer, has just beat Ivan Reaver.
It wasn't even his move, it was from Theodore's brainbuster! Oh, we got to go to the back. Striker's got something to say. Let's hear what he's got to say.
Tonight is a big night for me. I finally get Pitbull one-on-one. Unfortunately, the belt's not on the line this time, but I'll eliminate him, prove I am the better guy, and then I'll move on and face the winner of TJ's match and whoever wins the tournament, etc. And apparently Grimhold. And then in the main event, I will regain my world title and become IWD world champion for two times. And I walk out tonight with that belt because I'm a showstopper. One last thing. Pitbull, you're on about your pit crew all the time. You're going to need a pit crew after I'm finished with you to put you back together again.
Wow, we're back, Striker fighting words then, as Ivan's also watching the match. His face looks... I would say defeated. He doesn't look his normal confident self. He's like, defeated. I can see it in his eyes. Oh, apparently, Pitbull's what to say. I guess he'd like what just happened, like go and hit behind it. Oh, he gets powerbombed, Bryce does.
Telling me, Striker, I need my own pit crew to put me back together again. That is a load of rubbish. You know why? Because I'm going to strike you down, and then I'm going to stop the show with you. Literally, before I go on to reclaim my title in the main event tonight and become two-time IWD World Champion. Champion, you whatever, Pitbull. You all talk like normal. Tonight, like I said, I will wipe the floor with you and prove to you and my fans how good I really am and why I'm the showstopper.
Wow, Pitbull was basically giving it back to Striker and out of nowhere he interrupted him. How disrespectful was that? Basically gave it back to him. Oh, apparently Pitbull's got more to say. We've seen the burning helmet to Bryce the best. Ow, I hurt. We got it back.
Ha ha ha, you're being so funny interrupting me. Always with the jokes, the comedian. You know, I'm the showstopper, I'm a comedian, I gotta stop the show. Big whoop. At least when I get in the ring, I get down to business. I've got one loss to my name. That is it, and I won't be adding any more. What can I say about you, on the other hand?
Wow, what's your thoughts what's just been said, Tyler?
It's just a constant war between the two of them. We need to get to the match here.
Yeah, this is a great match as well. We got the two underdogs going at it. I'm getting winner back. Striker's got something to say again.
Oh, God.
Oh, here we go. Go to the back.
Well, I think it's time to shut up and put up. Lay it all out in the ring, and we'll be done with this thing once and for all.
Wow, if I was right, then Striker just shut the conversation up and said, you know, let's forget this back and forth, let's end it in the ring. What do you think what you said?
I think that's a very smart idea because we're trying to announce here and they're sitting there sending in clips and we... Oh, wait, here we go. One.
Pinning Bryce. Two.
Two
advances.
The commissioner has just pinned Bryce the best and he is out.
So he's got to face Sir Dave for the commissionership on the line later and he's got an actual world title match too now. So we go to back to replay. Talk us through him, Tyler. Look at that amazing move.
What's to say? I mean, that's amazing. I mean, what a pin from Bryce. I mean, he snuck in there, got a little sneaky pin, but he did fairly pin him.
And Theodore pinned Crusher. And then he then pinned Bryce the best. Oh, what about Crusher? He said if he doesn't win, their relationship's over, wasn't it? His mental relationship. He failed Crusher again. Wow, I don't know what's going to happen with these two now. Over. Well, see, all that blood in the ring. Look, he's just an elbow. All that blood. Look, the guy gets up, walks away, brilliant. The next match is, of course, Pitbull and Striker, and the winner will move on to the main event for the world title shot.
The lights dim as a superstar will walk to the ring for his match.
It is Pitbull, and his pit crew goes wild for him. It's deafening in here. It's like Pitamania, even. Talk us to what you know about Pitbull.
He's fearless. He's all about pure wrestling, and I think he is going to take the win in this match.
He's only one loss to his name so far, and that's when he lost the world title. And wasn't that because TJ screwed him out of it, if I remember correctly?
Yeah, and he also said that he is not adding any more to his record.
Yeah, so in other words, he's winning tonight, and then he will advance the main event and defend his newly won world title.
That's the kind of confidence that you need going into a match like this.
Yeah, should I rephrase that? He will win to get Striker, then he will advance to the main event and win the world title. The belt's not in line in this match. Originally it was, I wasn't confused. Originally it was him defending in Striker, but because of Grimhold giving him his only loss, that's why the belt has moved.
The stakes are higher than ever as the lights dim again.
Both of these two got a chance to become the two-time AEW champion.
Striker is making his way from backstage for his match against Pitbull.
Yeah, and the crowd go berserk. These are two fan favorites. You know, who's like most popular in our business today? I think it's got to be Striker, Pitbull, and probably Gary. Who else is? Oh, and Sir Dave, of course. Other than them four, I don't think you've got anyone more popular than them four. And we got two of the most popular people of all time in the ring tonight. Two of the best trash talkers in the ring tonight, as you heard earlier. Two of the best high flyers in the ring. Two of the speediest guys. Two of the biggest hearts. This is going to be incredible.
Simply two of the best that we have to offer are facing here tonight.
Definitely, definitely. Ivan's also up there in the best, but he lost early tonight. And he's not a fan favorite. The crowd despise him. Same with TJ Eclipse. He's also up there, but the crowd despise him too.
And the match begins. Begun.
This is hardcore. This is a hardcore match.
Oh, already flattening his opponent with a weapon of his choosing.
Yep. Oh, back and forth now. He dropped it to go a bit more wrestling style.
Man, those strikes have to hurt.
From Striker. Oh, what's this? On the candlestick!
Oh, gosh.
That's gotta hurt. Ow, I'm surprised his head isn't cut open already after that shot.
Bouncing off the ropes.
RKO!
Wow.
On the Kendall again, wasn't it? That was incredible. He's whipping it again.
Striker has amazing speed and amazing countering abilities.
Yeah, but Pitbull seems to be all Pitbull so far. Let's see what Striking... Oh, when I said Joe Pitbull so far, Striking comes back!
A counter.
With an arm drag. There's your counter ability, as you said. Oh, we got to go to back. Ivy's got something to say. As we see, oh, power driver!
Seriously, you want to ask me what I feel like after just losing that match? After I just lost that match? After I was pinned by... Oh, I didn't let me say his name. Just I'm gone. Forget it. I'm out of here. Happy man, I've got your back and all, but you don't need me. You can do it on your own tonight. I'm gone.
Wow. I said Ivan's face looked defeated. He just basically said he's leaving Happy Man on his own. He's leaving the building. What's your thoughts on what he had to say as this amazing match continues?
Well, like you said, this isn't like Ivan. I mean, this loss really hit him hard. He went in there with confidence and, you know, I'm going to win. I'm going to beat everyone. I'm going to be the new world champ. And it was just completely crushed with a loss. I mean, I'm disappointed too.
Yeah. And the fact that he should stick around to watch Happy Man's back. He's defending the extreme title later. But he said, you can do it. I'm gone. I've got word he's walked out the building. Oh, it's Pitbull top rope. Oh,
wow, what a move.
What amazing.
Top rope clothesline.
Yeah, an aerial clothesline. That was incredible. Okay, oh, out of nowhere. Back and forth this match.
It's amazing.
Oh, it's Striker leaving. Oh, he's getting a kendo stick. Pitbull is. No, he's not. What's going on? Striker's getting a kendo stick. What's Pitbull doing?
Watch out, Striker. Watch out. Oh, my gosh. What a nice top rope move.
That was insane.
He jumped out of the ring. And risked it all just to hit Striker.
Remember when he did that move to pin TJ for the title? That's how he won the belt, but TJ was down. Low blow
here.
He put the kendo across his throat at the time, if you remember.
What's he doing? Okay.
Oh!
Whatever he's doing didn't work.
No, I think he was getting a bit dazed. Don't, wait. And he got smashed in the face. Pitbull, screw you. No. He wanted a little breather. He wouldn't give it him.
In a grapple here.
Because Pitbull is a fan favorite, but he will low blow when he has to.
Backbreaker. That is just rattling the spine.
Definitely. He's not like having low blows at left, right, center. He will do what's necessary to win. Oh!
A power bomb on the ramp. Reminder, that is pure metal.
Yeah, that is ridiculous. Oh! He dropkicked the kendo in his face. That was good counter by Striker, who's about to get smashed in the face again, and he countered it with his feet. The kendo
Striker
to the
with the counter. He's going for
power bomb.
Wow!
This is back and forth. Oh, he's now posing to the crowd. Look at Striker pose. Wow, he is posing. And look at the Pitbull. He's telling the crowd. He goes, "Come on, get behind me." Oh, Striker's leaving. Where's he going?
I don't know. It looks like Pitbull is following though. A little cat and mouse here.
But it's a mind games between the two, I believe. Oh, we've got kendos. Oh, he just put his in the ring. What's he going to do? Oh, he's going back out. Oh, he's in the ring. He's a bit back and forth. He's a bit of mind game play.
Oh, he's going to get caught here.
As we go to the back. That was incredible. Oh, his balls exploded with that shot. His balls exploded.
I'm still fired. Of course. Bryce also failed me. This couldn't be any worse. Bryce better win his match later for that extreme title. Or else I'm very, very sure that our relationship will be over, and you will be crushed.
I mean, he seems kind of a bit like a hypocrite. I mean, I understand he's trying to bring out his full potential like we were just talking about during that little clip there, but I mean, you can't give up on rough times like this.
Yeah, but in Crusher's eyes, he's here to crush people, and he wants his protege to do the same. Yes, he also lost the match earlier, but at the end of the day, he's a bigger star than Bryce. Compared to him, Bryce is nobody. He's on his way up to be a somebody, but he isn't there yet. And I think that's what Crush is using to fire him to push him. And he's getting very frustrated with the guy's losses because he doesn't seem to be listening to his teachings. I think that's what it comes to. As look at this, Pitbull's giving it back to him.
Wow.
As we have go to the back, Teodoro's got something to say. Wow, he broke the stick across his head, across his chest.
I feel great. I feel beaten and battered, but I feel great to advance in a tournament. That world belt would be mine. It's a great honor to be wrestling alongside my great leader, TJ Eclipse. I can't wait to win. And another thing I've got to add very quickly. Because Tiger went loopy, because Tiger got screwed out of his title opportunity, I'm not going to give him a world title opportunity, but I'm going to be a nice guy. I'm going to give him extreme title opportunity. That's right, I'm entering in the extreme title match tonight.
So my sources early were correct. I mentioned that Tiger's getting put in that match.
Well, you kind of gave me a look like, that's not even happening. My sources were right. Someone's overheard Theodore planning it. Oh, look at this, back and forth!
Oh, my gosh.
He's wearing him out!
Look at the kendo stick, just covered in blood.
Yeah, it's bending, isn't it?
Oh my gosh, it's right bending. Across the chest. This could break a rib.
Yeah, and Stryker in past companies had rib problems. That's well documented when he came to ours.
This is not good.
He broke it, split it onto his...
This could be the end of Stryker.
And this could be the end of Matt.
One, two...
But Stryker, it's time!
Three!
And he wins, Pitbull wins!
Sir Dave wins, my prediction was actually right.
Pitbull actually, you said Sir Dave! Hopefully Sir Dave will win later.
Pitbull.
Hopefully Sir Dave will win later, again.
I want him to win too.
Go to the match replays. Talk us through these, Tyler.
Wow, I mean...
Showstopper loss, wow.
I'm excited because the person that I wanted to win won, and my prediction was right for the first time.
You got his name wrong afterwards. Look at that move. That was incredible.
Even when I'm right, I'm still wrong.
Yep. Look how he's bending the kendo with this. And in a minute, he splinters it.
These were just brutal shots, and Stryker just couldn't take it anymore.
No, could you take that? Just again and again. Look, he broke it.
He broke two.
Yeah, cross Stryker. Wow. Two and a three. And look at that sign. Strike it is your time. As he gets pinned. Game look, Reaver will not win. Guess that guy was right as well. That guy was right. The other guy was wrong.
All right, guys. We're moving on to our next match.
The world title.
The winner of this match moves on to the main event for the IWD world title.
The winner will be the world champ and will then have to defend it in the main event. So we could have a new world champ here and then he may lose it in the next match. Or Grimhold could defend it. So we have to get through two defenses.
Will the winner of this match keep the belt?
That's Grimhold.
For a while, or will they lose it in the next match after this one?
Yeah, exactly. TJ could become two-time world champ by winning this, then lose it in the main event. Or Grimhold could defend it, and then and lose it in the main event. Or he could defend in both titles.
Wow, look at the pyro.
Yeah, this is
awesome.
This is amazing.
This is thanks to all you guys that, you know, give us the budget to do this. We couldn't do this without you.
Yeah, thank you, fans. As you see, we're sold out. Look at the arena. Look at that arena.
It's amazing. It's just packed.
Brilliant. We were up to about 50-ish fans before, and now it's thousands. Wow.
I mean, the energy here is ecstatic.
Yeah, it's amazing. You can feel it. Lights go out. Who's going to come out now? Which one of the next two wrestlers of the match? Who's it gonna be? It's Theodore! The man earlier who won the tournament! The guy who's already wrestled! You've gotta think he was the underdog early, he's super the underdog now! Unless he's gonna help his leader win!
So far, he is the man of the night, and he is making one hell of a dent in this pay-per-view.
Definitely. But he's in there with his leader. Is he gonna help? He said earlier in the night that, you know, he can't wait to be in the ring with his leader. Is that because he's gonna help his leader win? Or will his leader do him the favor and let him win?
I don't know.
Will this be a handicap match versus Grimhold?
We're going to find out later tonight.
Because obviously the rules should be triple threat, but you don't know with this. Because we've got two executioners in the ring. The people who named this current pay-per-view. Because the commissioner named it. That guy in the ring with his leader named this pay-per-view. The Kingdom of Punishment. And at the moment, he's living up to that. For Theodore especially. And what happened to Stryker? Well, that was punishment. He was in the Kingdom getting punished again and again and again by none other than Pitbull.
Coming
as here comes
straight
the world champion walks through the flames himself.
Coming straight out of the depths of hell, Grimhold, the IWD world champion.
Will he still be after this match?
I don't know.
What's your thoughts on this match, Tyler, as he makes his entrance?
Grimhold is
scary.
Grimhold's completely fearless, but he does put the fear in his opponents, and I mean,
definitely,
it has to be scary standing in a ring with a guy of his size and a guy with his record and a guy that is the IWD world champ.
Yeah, because TJ's big, but he's not as big as Grimhold, but he does have Theodore as backup, we believe, for this match. But again, will Theodore hand it to him? We know Overlord's done that in the past. Overlord's handed commissionership in the past to Theodore. He's helped give the world title in respect to TJ. He's even helped with the stream title for a grasshopper. He won it, then gave it to him.
His triple threat is on the way. Reminder, the winner of this will move
on to
the main event later tonight.
Did you see that? TJ caught Grimhold in that amazing move, slammed his dropkick, and out of nowhere, Theodore jawbreaked him. Jawbreak Theodore. Theodore jawbreaked TJ. There are too many T's in this match. This is great. I'm so excited. Oh, he's bouncing off the ropes. RKO. TJ Eclipse has got a kendo. Oh, across his gut, he got to his feet. Oh, he's blocking him. Oh, he couldn't block that. Unless the head is a block. I don't think it is somehow.
Oh, Grandma's leaving. What's this about? As he gets hit in the head. He's leaving the two executioners to battle it out. What do you think, Tyler?
Oh my gosh.
Oh, Grimmo's got one. TJ hasn't seen it. TJ hasn't seen.
Whoa.
Whoa, that was an amazing move by TJ.
His kendo shots really end up.
Like I said, he had seen him. Wow. Oh, speaking of TJ clips, apparently he has something to say before the match. Let's go to the pre-recorded now as he gets his kendo in his hand once again.
This match is everything. It is my rise. It is my vengeance. It is my way back up the ladder here in IWD, and it's my championship. Me and Theodore will not be working with each other, but if it happens to go that way, it's fine with me as long as I win. This match is about me and only about me. And sorry, Theodore, but if I have to pin you for a three count to do that, I will do exactly that. Because this show is about me.
Wow, well, never guess the show's about TJ Eclipse. You named it last two pay-per-views, and this one, so that's three pay-per-views. And as he's trying to steal the show with that move, wow. That, I have to admit, that was impressive. That bit was. Okay, oh, that was impressive how his face smashed into the ground there. Very impressive. The Grimhold's got his kendo stick, oh, in his head. Oh, was Theodore abandoning his leader? Is he leaving? You got a title match here, what are you? Oh, he's getting for the kendo stick. What's your thoughts, what's happening, Tyler?
Very brutal as we have TJ falling off of his feet with blood all over his face.
He just broke it across his crotch. It splintered across his balls. He's like waving to the fans, and Theodore is taunting. He's
holding onto the ropes, trying to pull himself up.
Yeah, look, Grimmo's just staring at him, staring him down.
Doesn't have the strength.
Oh, he did that. He got two kicks in a row in the face.
Double drop kick from Theodore and Grimhold.
That was vicious, definitely vicious. Who would you give this match to so far watching this?
I would say advantage. Theodore seems to be the one that's dishing it all out and seems to be the one that's ranking first place so far.
That was surprising, so he's in there two bigger guys. Oh, has TJ had enough now? Where's he going? What's TJ doing? He's taking a little stroll. Where's the TJ off to? Oh, is he having a breather because he's been getting his butt whooped for the past 5 minutes? At why he's letting them two fight it out and then sneak in and get the pin? Is that what he's trying to do?
I don't know, whatever works.
See, what he's doing is the plan of his. Oh, as we go to the back, Striker's got something to say.
You're asking me right now what I feel about losing to Pitbull. I feel horrible about it, but I'm a man. He beat me fair and square. If you count repeatedly battering me with a kendo stick again and again and again and again and again and again and again, basically fair and square, then yeah, he beat me fair and square. Fact is, without that kendo stick, he wouldn't have won. Simple as that. And not only that, the only reason he was so good at hitting me again and again and again and again with that kendo stick, because he's used to doing something else with that arm, again and again and again, for a simple reason, because nobody loves him. That's right, he's a lonely little pit bull. His pit crew and all that is just a figment of his imagination. They pity you, Pitbull, but that's nothing more than pity for throwing you. Them cheers are pity.
Wow, that was some stinging words by Striker. What do you think, Tyler, what do you just have to say?
There's a lot of ways to go about winning a match, and that's the way that he felt was most suitable for that moment. And I have to say, yeah, it was repeated strikes, but I mean, that's totally legal, so I don't see that as a big problem. I think he's just mad that he lost.
It's a hardcore match. TJ's pinning. Oh, I thought TJ was going to allow him to get the pin. Then he waited 2 seconds, and now he's stomping his leader. Was that him, like, you know, you pin him, leader, and out of nowhere turns on him? Is that what that was?
I don't know.
Wow. To me, with that thing with Striker, though, personally, I think Striker, at first it started off, you know, he beat me fair and square. Oh, wait, 1 minute, we're getting the pin. He's pinning TJ!
Two!
He pinned his leader! Wow, he just pinned his leader!
Game over.
Wow, TJ, the leader of the executioners, is out of the tournament. He just lost his title. Oh, it's real! I don't want the world championship match! Theodore is our world champ! Theodore is our world champion! Wow! He's got one more match to be the main event to defend it, to walk away tonight as the true champion. But he is now our world champion! He just defeated Grimhold by pinning TJ. What's your thoughts on that?
A lot of things going through my head right now.
Wow. Wow, my mind is blown. His second match of the night, he was the underdog in both matches. The underdog in both matches. Three. Yet now he's our world champion. Game he's got one more defense tonight to stay that. And he's just got to take on Sir Dave for the commissionership. Speaking of which, we have the Extreme Championship match up next. Happy Man vs. Overlord. There's Tiger versus Bryce the Best. Again, Bryce already wrestled tonight. So he's another guy doing double duties. The difference is, he lost earlier. Can he change it around this time? What's your thoughts as Happy Man comes out? Again, with no Ivan backing him, he's out of the building.
This is a very important match. I mean, this is for the Extreme title. This is something that a lot of these people have been wanting since they entered this industry.
Yep, and here's the champion. We're looking right at him. And he's only by joining with Ivan when he finally got it. And Ivan's been backing the whole time, and now he's got no Ivan in the background.
Will he keep the title, or will it change hands tonight?
I don't know. I really don't know. What's your thoughts on the situation?
Well, I think the percentage of him losing it is very great in numbers because, I mean, look at the people that are going to be competing for this.
Yeah, the 1% he's got high in, though, is Bryce has wrestled once tonight and he's already had the loss. But maybe that's going to burn him even more desire to win. Maybe that would be the opposite effect. But again, he's got the added pressure of Crusher. If you fail this, wow, he's out. He's going after him. What's your thoughts, Tyler, as we... another member of the Executioners.
That's a lot to hold on your shoulders, especially as a young wrestler, you know, starting out in this business, trying to make a way, you know, a way to the top and trying to make something of himself.
Definitely. And that's something. Teodoro just pinned his leader. Is that going to cause some trouble in the Executioners? If it is this man's mind on the job? Is he thinking, like, what just happened? He just pinned our leader.
I know it, you know, the leader, which happens to be TJ Eclipse, he's definitely not happy because he lost that title and he really wanted it back, and Teodoro knew how much he wanted it back. But at the same time, TJ did say it's every man for himself, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. But half the time he says one thing and he does something else. We know he likes smokes and mirrors. He wants you to think this, why he's supposed to have you in the back. And here comes another executioner. So we got two executioners in this match. But like last match, I had two executioners in, and who came out on top? An executioner. This time we got two. Who's going to come out on top? If the last match is anything to go by, it's going to be an executioner. Because obviously we've got a fresh Happy Man. Who, remember, this dude, this tiger, this monster, dropped the stage on top of Ivan over 2-3 weeks ago. Then, granted, Ivan beat him last week when he came back. Well, last night, should I say. But he went a bit loopy, so that could go against him. Is his head 100% better?
I don't know, but this guy is a complete monster, and I know that whatever state of mind he's in right now, he will still do a lot of damage.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, it's the match beginning. We got somebody else to come out.
The lights go out.
One more person.
Our last
Bryce.
Contestant, Bryce.
He's got so much pressure on him.
The question that is going through his head and everyone else that is behind him, can he win and will he disappoint his mentor?
Yeah. And if he disappoint him, what's Chris going to do? What's Bryce going to do?
I don't know. I guess we'll have to see if it happens.
This pay-per-view is like, we've got two people here, mentor and teacher, could be splitting up. And then we've also got the executioners who's a little fumble in between them.
Seems to be like they're crumbling from the inside.
Yeah, look, Ivan, a Happy Man. Ivan's not here, he walked off. It's like every group, team, has got a lot of friction tonight.
And Happy Man, I know he can't be happy about that because, I mean, you know, that's supposed to be his friend, that's supposed to be his partner, and this is a big match, and I know that he wants him here for it.
Yeah, even though he did say he doesn't need him, I feel he said in the back he didn't need him, but we'll find out. Because even Ivan said to Happy, you don't need me. Is this like his, you know, you can do it on your own now, I'm letting you free, do it. You don't need me to hold your hands no more, you can do it. Is that this type of thing? Is he cutting the apron string, so to speak?
I can't tell you, I don't know.
Or is he truly just that depressed, you know, I'm lost, I'm gone. Forget it. You know, I don't care if you win or not, but I'm just going to say, yeah, you can do it. And leave. Oh, speaking of which, Happy Man is getting killed as he leaves the ring. So far, the champ is losing. Oh, we have a count out. The ref is counting him out. 2. Happy Man didn't get back in on a 10 count. He will lose his title. Oh, it looks like he's going for it. Look, he's calling to the crowd. Look how he's letting the other three beat each other up. That's smart on his part. He's going in to break the count, is he?
He's getting his energy back. Definitely. He's got to get inside to break the count. Okay, he broke it.
Remember, Bryce has already wrestled. The other two are fresh, but we still got a question mark over Tiger's health. Oh, he's getting out of the ring. He doesn't want anything part of him. The champ's letting the free fight. Oh! This is a good strategy. Look at him. He's going, yeah! This is a good strategy by the champ, do you think?
Oh, so before you answer, we're going to the back because apparently Happy Man had something to say earlier tonight, pre-recorded.
So Ivan's going home, is he? That is fine by me. I don't need him to back me up tonight. So I'm in there with Overlord. I'm in there with Bryce, the not-so-called best. And apparently Tiger, who I have beaten into a pulp many times before. I will walk away as the Extreme Champion. As I walk in the Extreme Champion. Cause it's gonna be happy days for me. I'm sorry it was sad days for Ivan today. But I will put a smile on his face by bringing my stream title home. Happy days, people. Happy days.
And we're back. While Happy Man was talking, did you notice in the ring, I think Overlord was getting pinned. Happy Man rushed in the ring and then he got speared by Overlord after he kicked out. And now he's kind of getting beaten by Bryce. What do you think of what Happy Man just said?
Well, I mean, that's great that he's contributing this match or tributing this match to Ivan because he wants to make Ivan proud of him.
Look at that! Burning hammer! Wow! From over the 7 foot tall to the other 7 foot tall dude. Oh, Bryce! Is he going to win it? Oh, no! Rope break! Rope break! The ref saw Happy Man's hand was on the rope. He gave it a rope break. Look at Happy Man! Look at him run! Wow! Happy Man's caught again! This is not going Happy Man's way. I think last week, actually, he kind of got his behind taken to it quite a lot, didn't he? Until the second Grasshopper interfered, who happened to be Ivan. And then it turned it around and he beat Grasshopper. Otherwise, Grasshopper, I believe, would have been here tonight because he was killing Happy Man that match. Happy Man, Grasshopper, who's not here tonight, came back, you know, with a vengeance. And he almost destroyed Happy Man. What's been happening now? See that? He went for a low blow and got caught. Because Grasshopper, remember, it's not scheduled to be here tonight. What's your thoughts on the match before we go to the back to listen to Grimhold?
Very exciting so far. The tensions are very high and everyone just giving it everything they have.
Job shooter. He taps out now, it could be over. And like I said, we go to the back in a second. Oh, double submission! Grimhold, the former world champ, to see what he's got to say. I think we should go to the back now.
So Theodore pinned his leader to win my title off me. He didn't pin me, so in other words, they had this planned because it's the only way they could beat me. Fair dues to them, mind games and everything. But the thing is, you better watch your backs, executioners. You know why? Because it's going to be very grim for you lot.
Okay, and we're back. What's your thoughts on what he just said to Grimhold, that former world champion, Tyler Steele?
Well, they just made an enemy that you don't want to have.
Did you see that baby happy? He caught the big guy in midair, threw him down, and the big guy's speed got straight back to his feet. Oh, they're tripping over each other! This match ain't going well for Happy Man, is it? Well, as you're saying about Grimhold, it seems they used mind games. They didn't pin him, they had to pin each other. There's no way they could beat him. And he said, that's fair dues, but you just made an enemy of me, basically.
Well, yeah, I mean, they just stripped the title off of him.
Yep, and he only had it. He won it not last week, the week before. So he's had it just over a week, gone on 2 weeks. So he's not the shortest champ, unfortunately, that's Striker's honour. If you call it an honour. But he's up there. But he's also the only former Extreme Champion and former IWD World Champion we have. Who's had them both. What's very impressive. No one can take that away from him at the moment. Because none of these guys are former World Champs in the ring. So even if anyone wins it now, they can't claim that. As this match continues. Who'd you give this to so far? Who do you think is going to win this? Who's your pick?
And why? I would have to say,
oh, look at that move by Bryce. That was impressive.
Bryce and Happy Man.
Why?
Oh. Well, Happy Man, he's dedicating this match to Ivan, and he doesn't want to disappoint him. And also, Bryce, I mean, you have to think about it. He's got a lot on the line. Not only is this for a title, this is for, you know, this is for his mentor. This is for himself. Definitely. He's got to win this.
So if you had to pick them between Happy and Bryce, who are you going with?
I would have to say Bryce.
Bryce, okay.
Bryce. I mean, he's an underdog, but I mean, he's been proving himself. He did lose his last match, and
Happy Man going high.
And he hasn't been doing that great lately, but I mean,
ooh,
he did pin Ivan.
Yeah, he did. But at the same time, it was off. Wasn't Theodore's brainbuster? Wasn't even his move.
he was ultimate opportunist, got in there and got the pin.
But it was.
If he does that here, it's one pin that wins. If he does the same thing here, he's an extreme champion. And that's all it takes. Oh, speaking of which, he's going high as his back and neck gets snapped by Happy Man. What powerbomb. Oh, he's pinning him. Oh, he kicked it out. Oh, it's a rope break. We're going to the back. TJ Eclipse has got something to say. Oh, what a move.
Cannot believe you, Tidor. How selfish you are. What more power do you want? You're already the commissioner. I went into that match for one reason only, to reclaim what is mine, the IWD World Championship, and you took that away from me. I promise to you that consequences will follow.
Oh, we almost had a two count right there, Happy. Almost won as we back from what TJ just said. As luckily, Tiger made the save to keep this match alive.
What do you think about what TJ had to say?
He sounded very annoyed. Very annoyed with Theodore. And didn't he have this whole thing lean into this that, you know, he couldn't believe, well, he lost confidence in Theodore. He thinks and he thought he was going to lose his commission match. What hasn't happened yet could still happen. I don't think he expected him to get as far in the tournament as he did. And then go on to beat him. Almost had a pin.
But I can understand his frustration, you know, when he first started out with this promo. Well, not really promo, his little clip after the match, saying, what more power do you want? And you have to agree, Theodor is very greedy. He wants it all.
And he's done a lot of mistakes for the group in general. Hasn't he? Over the you know, he gave Striker temporary commissionership at one point. What backfired a lot because all three of them got title matches. You know, Ivan did, Gary did, Striker did. After he thought he dealt with Striker.
Oh, we got a pin.
Two.
One, two,
three. Happy Man's still the extreme champion. He didn't need Ivan after all. Wow. And to me, he got his butt taken to him back and forth. And he looked like he was probably going to lose. And then he gets the sneaky pin.
What is going to happen to Bryce?
Oh, yeah, with Crusher. Wow, I completely forgot. Wow. That ain't good, but Crusher's fired, so maybe he won't be landing building? I don't know.
I don't know if that's going to stop
normally,
him.
Yeah, you can't normally stop Crusher. Remember our first pay-per-view, we lost all our profits because he destroyed the back when he lost.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was bad. Very bad. And we got a lot more special equipment this time round. So somebody look
it's
after Crusher.
That's a good thing.
Yeah. Give him some tea. Give him some biscuits. Keep him happy. Please. What a match replays. We're going back and forth here in these replays. And there he is, raises his arm with both executions staring him death beams. Look at him like, you son of a little...
It seems like it's only going good for Theodore.
Seems so far, because what is it, two matches he's won tonight so far? He's got to... He could lose everything yet, though. He's going to get Sir Dave with the commissionership. He could lose that. He would then be in the main event defending his newly won world title against Pitbull. He could lose
all
that.
All right, the next match, everything. Sir Dave versus Theodore,
the winner the commissioner.
Is the new commissioner...
Or the old commissioner.
Or the same commissioner.
Yeah. So it's Theodore's third match of the night. Now I said, from this point on, the start of the pay-per-view has gone all his way. This second half could go completely opposite. He could walk away with nothing now. If he loses to Dave, he's lost commissionship. He then could take some Pitbull, loses, he's lost the world title.
Walking down to the ramp is the Sunset Rider, pure wrestler, Sir Dave.
Yeah, he wants to win this to get pure wrestling back the way it should be. That was awesome. Look at them. That's fireworks. What are fireworks? Fireworks with pyro. When you pyro, fire wire work. Yes. Not to your door. What's your name? Tyler Steele. Take over for me. I'm having a drink of water.
This is really exciting. This is, I mean, the new commissioner. I mean, this could be a new commissioner. We don't know. But, I mean, it's all on the line here.
And remember, last pay-per-view, Sir Dave defeated Theodore. And they were both fresh. Today, this time, we've got fresh Sir Dave and battle-hardened, two matches to his credit, Theodore already. He's got to be getting tired. And straight after this match, if some miracle he wins or he loses, he's in the main event instantly. So he'll come out, do another entrance after replays. He's going to go back. We're going to have a little talk with him, get him patched up if he's bleeding, and he'll be back out here. So he's going to have a little break, but not long. So his best interest is to end this match as quick as possible if he wants to keep the commissionership and move on for the world title. He's got to end it as quick as possible. If he doesn't, everything he's worked for, everything he's achieved tonight, is gone up in smoke like a pyro behind him. What's your thoughts on the situation as we begin this match?
Fight! Well, the stakes were high, but they're a lot higher. He is the new crowned world champ and is commissioner. But the real question, will he remain commissioner?
Yeah, and remember, the world title is not on the line in this match. It's on the line in the match after this against Pitbull. So Sir Dave Winty will not be the commissioner and the world champ. He will just be the commissioner.
But, I mean, like you said, he won't be world champ. But, I mean, he will be able to control Theodore. And that's not good.
But the thing, yeah, especially because he says if he wants pure wrestling back, if you're not going to listen to pure wrestling, he's going to make your life a living hell. But obviously, if you fall in line to his pure wrestling, he's going to be fair with you. Oh, look at that move! Wow, that's not what Theodore needs at the start of the match. Having a flying Sir Dave from a top turnbuckle, crashing down on him, having the candlestick smash across his head, then be thrown into the metal security railings. That is not what he needed. What's your thoughts as this match continues?
It's very exciting. I mean, they already brought it outside the ring, and it looks like they're trying to get an advantage here, but they're both even in strength,
yeah.
It looks like.
Shot then by Sir Dave. He caught him.
Wow.
I thought he got the block up in time, but
he
wasn't. He
tried to block it, but his kick was too strong.
Definitely. Oh, that metal's too strong on his back.
Ow.
There's the kendo stick again.
Going for a shot here. Man, that really hurt.
Ooh, sugar. Definitely sugar. That was the worst sugar I've ever seen in my life. Wow. As we go to the back, because Happy Man's got something to say. I'm assuming about his win. Let go. So Dave enters the ring.
What did I tell everybody? Simple. I'll walk in the stream champion as walking out the stream champion. Happy days, people. Happy days.
And we're back to this intense match with so much at stake. So Happy Man basically saying he said he's going to win, and he did win. So it's happy days. Oh, what a powerbomb! What's your thoughts what Happy just said? And the match as Theodore's leaving the ring.
What he said is exactly right. He set out to win, and that's exactly what he did, and he ended up raising his hand.
What's going on? What's going on? Oh, my. No, he's not. Look, he's not seeing him. Oh! He bent over to pick the candlestick, but he smashed his back. Wow. He's like, no more. Look at him. No more. Oh, and now he's cut open again for the third time tonight. He's already had like two sets of stitches ready tonight. He obviously needs them again. Oh, this ain't good. No, he's going to be in the mat. Oh, he's on the mat, but the mat is thin. It's concrete underneath this. Talk us through the match, Tyler.
Well, I was talking to you, interrupted me again.
Shush you, talk us through the match.
Well, anyways, like I was saying, Happy Man set out to do exactly what he was planning on doing, and he won, and he ended up raising his hand in victory. And he was one of my two predictions.
But then when you had to pick between the two, you went with Bryce.
I was hoping that Bryce was going to win because consequences are very high now.
Definitely. Like, what's the crusher going to do with him? Oh, look at that. He's like, he blocked the first few, but he couldn't block it again. Oh, he dodged that one barely. Oh, no, this is going to be on the concrete. No.
That's got to hurt.
Yeah, that could be right. You could have pinned him then. I think it would have been over after that move. Oh, what a shot.
Sir Dave's fighting back, though. That pure wrestling seems to, take control of him.
Definitely. This has been a war. This has been a very aggressive war. What's going on here? Oh, he's gone again.
Oh, got him. Just caught him.
He almost hit the skull terrain himself then. He almost backfired and hurt himself then, Sir Dave did. That was a big risk. I think it paid off, though. It came close to crashing and burning, though. He's got to be careful. He doesn't go up high too often, and he's bleeding all over the place and crashes and burning. Because if that happens, Theodore could take the advantage and somehow sneak the win, like he snuck the win with TJ. Whoa, look at that move! He put him off it! He slammed him on the concrete!
One.
Two. He's done. Oh, I thought we had a new commissioner! I honestly thought we had a new commissioner at that point! Oh! What did you think that was over then? I did.
I mean, that was a huge move, and that did a lot of damage.
He just caught him out of nowhere and just forced him down on the concrete. Like I said, it wasn't even in the ring, it was on the concrete, people! If you like Theodore, you hate Theodore, you've got to give him credit for that, the kick out of that. That was incredible. He's shown a lot of testosterone fortitude tonight. Definitely. Don't you feel, Tyler?
Yeah, definitely.
What's your thought on this match before we go to the back to listen to Bryce?
Very extreme, a back and forth battle. I mean, this is crazy. I thought it would have been over by now.
Definitely, this is... Whoa, uh-oh. We're going to see another pile driver? Oh, again, on that thin match of the concrete. Let's go to the back now for Bryce.
You're asking me what it feels like to lose and disappoint my mentor, and he says he's going to crush me. I'm sure we sort this out, because I look up to Crusher. He's taught me everything I know to prove to him that I'm a worthy apprentice, that I need him as my mentor. And I apologize from the bottom of my heart, right here and now, for all you. I apologize, Crusher, for failing you. I promise you I will never, ever fail.
What? That just happened? Someone just hit him! No, Bryce! Crusher! Look at, oh my, look at this! Oh! Again and again!
This is exactly what I predicted.
Yeah, look at, oh! This ain't good. This is what happens if you disappoint Crusher, if you're his student. Do not disappoint Crusher! Oh, he's crushing his rib with that candlestick! Oh, this is brutal, this is brutal! And again! Oh! Come on, just cut the feed, I can't take this! Get someone to bat split someone, just cut the feed! Oh, I'm sorry people, I just couldn't take that no more. I believe people are trying to separate him in the back, but, oh, look, time to take over, we got Kangaroo in this match, we got the sharpshooter. Oh, wow.
That was disturbing and absolutely brutal. I mean, I didn't want to watch it either.
No, that was horrible. And if Tito, I was going to say, don't get to the ropes or get out, he's going to tap, but he got out. Or did Tito Dave let him out? I think he let him out, for this.
Oh,
I think he just missed a candlestick. Oh, he's going high. He's going to end it.
Ooh, nice clothesline from top rope.
That was beautiful. He's got the candlestick. Oh, we're going to see a repeat of what we just saw in the back. No, he's not allowing it. He's not allowing it. Oh,
beautiful
counter. Wow. Who did you give this match to so far?
I would have to say Sir Dave. Sir Dave's been really dishing the pain out. I mean, whipping into the barricades, shots to the face,
the
slams.
The snake eyes.
I mean, these moves are going to win it if he continues this way.
Yeah, if he hits this, it's all over. Oh, he moved this Tito speed. Oh, he's going to pin him from it.
One.
Sir Dave made a mistake.
Two. Three.
Tito pulled it off. He's still the commissioner. Wow! Because that was a mistake by Sir Dave! Isn't that how he defeated Gary when the commissionership was on the line? Gary slipped off the turnbuckle. This time Sir Dave did not slip.
He overshot it.
Yeah, and he moved in time. His Theodore speed moved in time. That move, I thought it was over right here and there. On that replay, I thought that was over. The visions on that.
He just...
A normal wrestler, that would have been over. But look, he gets out of the way just in time. And I think his head or his leg caught that candlestick on the way down. I think that's what did it. He hit the candlestick. Wow. Okay, we're going to the back now to listen to the current world champion and the number one contender before the main event. Let's go. One more match. That's all it takes. One more match. And once again, a two-time world champion. IWD's world champion. All I've got to get through is Theodore, who's all gone through three people already. Well, three matches, should I say, where I've already gone through Striker. Striker on his own, give all respect to that guy. That was like going against five people at once, even though he didn't give me any respect in return. What are you going to do about it? But either way, I'm going to do this for all my pit crew out there and become a two-time IWD World Champion. I don't care to Theodore if you're commissioner or not. I'm walking away with this belt. One last thing to add, though. Be a man, Theodore. Be a man. And don't use your commissioner powers to screw this match over. If you're the better man today, you will beat me. If you're not the better man, I will beat you. And that should be the end result. Be a man for once in your life. Three matches I've won tonight. Three matches, people. Three matches. I even defeated my great, amazing leader. I defeated Sir Dave, who said he beat me last month. To keep my commissionership, the power stays with the executioners. Like I said, tonight is Kingdom of Punishment. And after I defeat Pitbull to defend my first title defense with this world title, this strap, I will be the true champion of IWD forever. And we're back. The main event, IWD World Championship, on the line. Pitbull, his second match of the night, taking on Theodore, his fourth match of the night. As they make their entrances, talk us through what they just said, Tyler.
Well, basically what Sir Dave said, Sir Dave, always getting confused, same hair. Anyways, Pitbull, he wants a match, a fair match, and he wants to win, but he wouldn't be as hurt if he lost to a fair match without any distractions, without Theodore using his commissioner powers to turn the match over to his side.
Yeah, like when he got TJ to win his belt originally. He restarted a match out of nowhere and he just attacked him and started the match after the Striker went through hell and back. And he had to defend it straight away and he wasn't expecting it. That's what he's talking about. Look at this entrance as well. And obviously the Theodore's. He said that he's won three matches tonight. He even respects his leader and he beat his great leader. Also, he didn't get the same respect earlier from TJ. He was really annoyed about it. He seemed fine about it. What's your situation with these two? What do you think? The way they acted with each other.
What are you talking about?
TJ Eclipse was really annoyed over the loss to him. Theodore, his little protege,
Theodore,
so to speak.
Theodore and TJ?
Yeah, and why Theodore just seemed to show respect and super respect to TJ, where TJ showed him
Theodore is the commissioner. But you have to remember, TJ is the leader of the Executioners, the most brutal group that we've ever seen, and the only group as far as we know. And if TJ does want to punish someone, he will punish them to the greatest extent that he is capable of.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, he's just trying to kiss butt to ease the punishment,
I guess. But at the end of the day, he's the commissioner. Theoretically, he could fire TJ on the spot if he wanted to.
Right.
He could, but I mean, even if you fired him, I don't think he would ever leave.
No, when he's got the other members, would probably turn on Theodore.
It just wouldn't be smart.
No, as this match starts, oh, out of the corner! He whipped Pitbull in the corner and he came straight at him and got caught with an RKO. So what's your thoughts on this match as it begins?
Well, like I said, you know, it might ease up a little bit if he wins this and keeps the title. It might ease things up between TJ and Tito, or at least say, well, at least the title's
Whoa.
In the group.
He got caught with the same move that Sir Dave caught him with earlier.
On.
He almost lost the title straight away. That was like the first 30 seconds. But again, this is his fourth match of the night. Pitbull has had one match or two, but he's had a big rest. He literally was just fighting back and forth with Sir Dave, wasn't he, Theodore? Pitbull has been resting since. So he is the fresher guy, remember that. Even though he did say take on Strikers like five people. So at least he gave Strikers some credit. Where credit's due, where Striker didn't really give him any credit. So who's your pick for this match then, to Tyler Steele? And why?
I have to say, Theodore's on a hot streak, but I mean, Pitbull, he's not out here to play. He's here to wrestle. He's here to win. But I have to say that I think Theodore's going to win this.
Why is this? Why is that?
He seems to be in the right state of mind. I mean, he's slowed down a little bit because, I mean, this is his fifth match. Fourth match.
Yeah.
And he's won three before this. So, I mean, you know, he could do it again.
Yeah, he could. This is like he was in the opening amazing four-way match for eliminations. Technically, he beat even more people than that. As we go to the back, Sir Dave's got something to say. Probably about what happened earlier with his match.
What I gotta say, well played to Theodore, well played. I did a mistake, he capitalized. Pure wrestling at its best. That was a war out there, I give you credit where credit's due. But like I said, I defeated you last month. You defeated me this month. Why don't you, as someone already said tonight, your next opponent Pitbull says, be a man. Let make it best of three. One all so far, next pay-per-view, you versus me. You don't need to put that world title on the line, even if you still have it, that is. I just want the commissionership on the line. One-on-one, if you're a man, let's settle this once and for all. Hey, I'll even put my career on the line if I have to get this done. What'd you say, are you a man or not? I don't mind waiting for your reply. And the next chronic pain. That's fair enough, because I know you're busy tonight. Ride on, people. Ride on and respect.
And we're back as Pitbull's blood spilling all over the place. Wow, what an amazing dropkick. What's your thoughts? What Sir Dave just had to say? And that challenge?
Well, I mean, the challenge is there, and he said he's ready to wait for a reply because he knows that he'll be busy tonight, and he's got nothing but respect for him.
Yeah, I don't think he respects him normally, but he respected what he did in that match. In his eyes, he won fairly. It was a mistake on his part. Well, Sir Dave's part why he won, but he won by pure wrestling. He didn't win by, TJ interference, overall interference, you know, that sort of thing. And it was a brutal war, and it was anyone's. I really hope he accepts, because like I said, these two have had two cracking pay-per-view matches with each other so far, so a third one next month, oh, that would be amazing to finally settle it. But it's up to Theodore if he will accept it. Or should I say, if TJ tells him to accept it. That's what normally happens with these two. Okay, this match is... Oh, what a shot to the face. Oh, they're slugging it out now. Oh, snapmare. These two look exhausted in there. But they're fighting. They are warriors. What's your thoughts?
Well, he's getting his face totally beat in. But, I mean, that's what you have to do in order to beat Theodore.
Yeah, and see that speed advantage there, and he went for the lion, so he moved just like he was Sir Dave, but then he turned into a dragon sleeper where Sir Dave pinned him and won.
He's got it really cinched in deep. You can see his face just like losing air, losing life.
Yeah, he looked unconscious almost. Oh no, he's getting back. Spoke too soon. Oh, drop kick to the face. Ow. Wow, what a kick. What a drop kick. Okay, sir. No, he stopped. I thought he missed him, but he didn't. I thought he missed him, but he didn't. That was close.
Well, you usually ask me this question, but who do you think is going to win?
That's hard. I would like to go with Pitbull. Because of... You know, he's undefeated other than one match. But then we always have the... Theodore, executioners, screwing things over. I think it depends if he's going to be a man. If he beats a man, Pitbull. If he's going to do his little cheaty, scaredy, coward, whiny, girly stuff, then he's going to come out on top. Or just say, put the belt back on TJ.
The only way that I see Theodore screwing him out of it is not the executioner way. I think that TJ is so fed up with Theodore right now, he could care less what happens with the belt. Because it's not around his waist. But... he is still the commissioner, so that is the main way, and maybe the only way that he could make it swing towards his way.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, I'm getting something in the back. We've got... Gary's here! I didn't know Gary's even here. He's on the card. He's in the back. He's got something to say. Let's go and see what he says.
You've done a pay-per-view without me. What is the madness? You need the insane madness that is going! Yes, you do!
Ow, that was creepy. That was creepy. Did you hear what you're saying? How dare you do a pay-per-view without me? And I haven't heard him laugh that widely before, and he laughed widely. What's going to happen?
Well, I told you that he'll probably end up coming anyways, and I mean, he feels like he's been disrespected, and he feels like he's earned a spot to be here, and, well, he's going to make us pay.
Yeah, well, is he going to affect this match, you think? The world title match?
He might, because Theodore, he's in charge of all the matches. He's in charge of... who goes where in what pay-per-view in what show. So he could be screwing Theodore, and we could see Pitbull being the world champ.
Yeah, this match, thanks to Gary, just a little conversation by Gary, and the match is in the air. He just, you know, he comes over and just blinks at you. The match is in the air, and he's not even part of the match. Whoa, what a move!
Wow.
Oh, it's been a second time for that move! What? He almost went to make... Oh, so close! So
that
close!
Same move.
Yeah! The heart of Theodore is impressive. I've never seen him have this much heart before. Pitbull's going high. What's going to happen here? Oh, what a clothesline. Oh, he's stomping the mud hole in him now. Here he goes. Oh, right up to the back. If I was him, if I could roll him over, I'd pin him now. Just roll him over and pin him, Pitbull. No, he's going for that low back. I think he'll get up. Oh, where's he going? If that was me, I would have advantage. Why is he leaving? Oh, he must have something bigger planned. Oh, he blocked it. He's got something bigger planned. What's he going to do? The referee's counting. You see the two count. They both don't get back in the ring. We're going to have a double count out here. And Theodore will keep the belt if that happens, remember, people. If Theodore gets counted out, he will keep the belt. Okay, he's getting in the ring to break the count. Six. Okay, the ref should have break the count now. What's he going to do? Just going to be... ref's not break the count. What's the ref doing? What? No, the ref didn't break the count. He got back in, people. He got back in. The ref just did a double count out. Theodore's still the champ. They just screwed Pitbull out of the belt. He got back in what should have broke the count. That should have broke the count, people. The ref is in the commissioner's pocket. I believe that just saved his belt. What's your thoughts on what just happened as we go to replay?
Well, I told you that if he was going to do it, it was going to be the commissioner way, not the executioner, because TJ, like I said, he's really annoyed with Theodore right now, and you see that Theodore, before the match, before this all happened, he paid the ref.
Yeah, he took the easy way out. He won three amazing matches properly tonight.
And he won the fourth one, but not the way that he won all three before.
Yeah, because technically they didn't even win it. They both were counting out, so they both lost. But obviously you have
this
to beat
right here,
the champ.
His foot completely just smacked him in the face. He knew it was over, so he took the call.
Oh, he's in the ring. He's got the mic. We've got to listen to Theodore now. What's he going to say to us?
Like that, another one bites the dust. Now get my glorious leader out here for me. I've got a gift for you, leader. Come out. I need TJ Eclipse. Come to me, leader. Everybody said you lost faith in me. Everybody. I knew you hadn't really. And you're going to come out here and receive the gift I want to give to you. Why are you all booing? Stop booing me! Our leader's coming out with the executioners! Come on, leader! Come and get your gift!
Wow, fine words. Is TJ Clips going to show up? The camera's going around. TJ Clips is out there! Wow, I think someone's handing the mic now. Let's see what he's got to say.
This had better be good. I don't know if you saw the clip, but I'm so fed up with the way that you've been acting. You have totally abused your power. Have you forgotten that I am the leader? Well, whatever the gift is, it better make up for what you did tonight and the way that you have been acting.
and her fighting words, but we have to cut off from him quickly. I want to send appreciation to all our fans out there. Look at all these amazing fans in the crowd. What do you think, Tyler?
Well, I want to say thank you to all the people that support this. We would not be able to do this without you. I want to thank the people for letting us book this arena. I want to thank the people that made the ring for us, that let us customize it. I mean, this is amazing. I mean, this is crazy. I mean, it's the first... Oh my gosh!
He just got in the ring! He just got walloped!
Who is it? I think it's Tior!
What's he... That's the gift! He's turning on his leader!
Oh my gosh!
He caught him!
Whoa!
Gosh! In midair, he caught him!
Whoa!
He dropped the kendall, caught him midair!
Oh my god, that's amazing. Oh my... Another shot to the face!
Wow, this is incredible. This is incredible.
Oh my gosh.
What does it mean for the executioners? Whoa.
It's over now, that's all I can say.
Oh, he's bleeding all over himself. He is destroying his leader.
He's destroying what they made together.
Definitely. He broke it across his head. Oh, he's going to use a sharp end. Don't use a sharp end. Oh, he blocked the sharp end, luckily, but I think it cut his wrist. Oh, he's got another candlestick. This is bad.
Come
this
on, TJ. Bad. Fight back. Fight back, TJ.
Oh, this is bad. They said kingdom of punishment. He's punishing his leader. He's punishing the king of the kingdom. I guess the PPV name fits. Wow.
Oh, Black, yeah. Do something. Cover your face up.
This is not good. Oh, across his back. But he's got up. He's... Oh, he blocked. Oh, no, he didn't block it.
The get force, up, TJ.
The force of
get
the
up,
kick
TJ.
Forced him backwards. Oh, I got it.
Nice slam.
Get him out to him.
He's going for a pin.
He's pinning him. He's embarrassing him.
Two.
He's trying to embarrass him. He's like, you're not the champ. If I pin you, I deserve the belt. Trying to embarrass him from there. Oh, he's got the sharp end again.
Oh my gosh.
This is not good. This is not good at all. Oh, and again, that's across his chest. Are we going to have any more TJ after this? He could be retired. He could put him on the shelf for good. What's he doing there? Oh, he's back to his feet. What's he going to... Oh, just stay down, TJ. Stay down. I don't like you no more, but come on, even you don't deserve this. Just stay down. Oh, watch your force, Tyler, of the situation.
This is just too much. He needs to stay down.
Oh, stay down, TJ. Stay. Stay down, please. No. He's blocking it. No. It's not enough. Oh, man, this is ridiculous. He's like, get up. See him. You can see him and say, get up. Be a man, get up. But look, he just smashed another one across his head. He's leaving. TJ's back to his feet. TJ just stayed down. He was going. Wow. Watch your thoughts. Oh! Talk us through, Tyler. Oh.
This is just brutal. I mean, this is kind of like a... Kind of what happened to Bryce when Crusher attacked him.
But the difference with Bryce, he didn't get up again. TJ, can you get back to his feet? I think Bryce was unconscious and Crusher carried on.
He's not even letting him get up.
He keeps getting up and taking it. I think he would have stopped by now. He was leaving the ring, but no, he got back up and went straight after him. Oh
my gosh.
This is ridiculous.
Just need to stop.
Oh, he broke another one. That's three he broke. He's leaving, finally. He is leaving. Oh, he's grabbing the mic. Let's listen to what he's got to say. You want to know why you're lying unconscious, bleeding from your head? Because you lost faith in me. How dare you? The executioners are dead. Today, I take over. I'm the new leader. You are nobody. As Overlord destroys you in front of me. Tiger's turn now. Finish him. Grasshopper, now your turn. I didn't like your plan to begin with, Theodore. If this is the way executioners go, and screw it, I'm leaving. I will not go out there and attack my former leader. You're on your own, and you're just as weak as he is. I am the new leader. I am the best in...
Oh!
Gary just blocked him! What's he doing? Oh, he's blocking him now. Gary's going...
Come on, Gary.
What's going on? Oh,
he got
in
his face.
Oh, wait, the group just split up. This is...
Uh-oh.
Wow.
Uh-oh. He's picking him up.
No. Off the stage!
Oh, my gosh!
He went off the stage!
Yeah!
The group split up! Oh, Gary just dropped the World Champ Commission off the stage! Let's go, that good stuff is IVATOPIA'S and Dynasty!
Bye!